Welcome to this video on how to simulate gateway cloning with Geneious Prime. Gateway cloning is a two-step process. The first step, known as a BP reaction, involves the creation of a gene or DNA fragment of interest with flanking attB1 and attB2 sites. Then, the fragment is mixed with a donor vector containing attP sites and a BP clonase enzyme mix. The enzyme catalyzes the site-specific recombination to create an entry vector containing the insert flanked by AtL sites. In step 2, the LR reaction, the newly created entry vector is mixed with a destination vector containing AtR sites and the LR clonase mix. The resulting reaction creates the final expression clone with the insert flanked by AtB sites. This clone is then ready for transformation and expression in a host organism. That's a brief overview of gateway cloning. Let's now simulate this process in Geneious. Begin by designing primers to amplify a sequence of interest and incorporate the AtB sites required for the BP reaction. There are two ways to do this. Either click and drag to highlight your region of interest, or simply select an annotation on the sequence. Then, select the Primers button and choose Design New Primers. In the Design New Primers window, select Design New to create custom primers. Tick Forward and Reverse Primer. There's no need for a DNA probe in gateway cloning assays. Because we want Geneious to amplify a specific region, change the task to Precise. And since we selected the region of interest before opening the Design New Primers window, we can check the Included Region option here. Geneious will then populate the region values based on this selection. Geneious can also design a certain number of primer pairs. For example, entering 1 will create a single primer pair. Additional drop-down options allow you to adjust other settings, such as the melting temperature calculations and other characteristics, including the primer size, melting temperature, and GC content. To adjust a setting, simply enter your desired values into the boxes. Lastly, since these primers are for gateway cloning BP reaction, you need to add the appropriate 5 prime extensions. To add 5 prime extensions, select the Advanced option. Then select the Forward button to edit the forward primer extension in the pop-up window. Geneious has many extension options available, but for gateway cloning, select the Gateway Site option. Next, use the drop-down menu to select your desired site. For simple gateway cloning experiments, choose the AtB1 option on the Sense strand. Click OK. The preview window shows 4 guanine nucleotides will be added at the 5 prime end, followed by the AtB1 site. The added guanine nucleotides ensure the clonase enzyme can efficiently bind to the terminal AtB1 site during cloning. Repeat this process for the reverse primer. Again, select Gateway Site. But this time, ensure you select an anti-sense option, since this is the reverse primer. The AtB2 site is suitable for most simple gateway cloning experiments. When you're happy with the primer settings, click OK. You should now see the desired primers added to the sequence. Simply hover over each one to preview their characteristics, such as size, melting temperature, and GC content. Before proceeding, make sure you save your file by selecting Save, or use the keyboard shortcut. With the primers designed, let's simulate a PCR to extract the region flanked by the new primers. Go to the Primers button and choose Extract PCR Product. Use the drop-down menus to select the primers you designed earlier and click OK to extract the product. Geneious will create a new sequence file with inward-facing AtB1 and AtB2 sites, flanking the PCR product at either end. To extract the newly designed primer sequences for easy ordering, select the first primer in the sequence view, hold down the Control key, and select the second primer. Then click Extract. the exported sequences will appear as separate primer files in the document table. To export these files, select Export and choose Export Documents. For example, if you save the sequences in a .csv file, you can refer to them when you order the primers. Next, use the newly created PCR product and perform a BP clonase reaction with a donor vector containing a set of attB sites. To simulate the BP reaction, you will require a donor vector, such as pDonor221. Donor vectors contain the attP1 and attP2 sites needed for the BP reaction. The reaction replaces this region with the PCR product flanked by the attB sites. To perform the BP reaction in Geneious, select both the donor vector and the PCR product sequence files. Then, click Cloning and choose the Gateway Cloning option. Geneious will notify you that your two selected sequences will be used in the BP reaction. Click OK to confirm. The result of the BP reaction is an entry plasmid containing the PCR product with flanking attL1 and attL2 sites. These attL sites are essential for the final step, the LR reaction. After a BP reaction, it is advisable to perform a PCR on the E. coli colonies containing your clonase-derived constructs. This step ensures you have the correct construct before proceeding to the LR reaction. Most donor vectors should contain a set of primer binding regions that flank the ATL sites. For example, the pDonor221 vector contains the M13 forward and reverse primer binding regions, making them suitable targets for PCR. For the last step, use the newly created entry plasmid and perform an LR reaction to produce the final expression clone. To do this, you will need a destination vector, such as pDest17, which contains the attR1 and attR2 sites. These attR sites will recombine with the attL sites on the entry clone. To simulate the LR reaction, select the destination vector and the entry clone, then select Cloning and choose the Gateway Cloning option. Since the LR reaction creates two products, it is possible to save both sequences as separate files by ticking this option. I will leave this unchecked for this example and only return the final expression clone sequence. In the next window, Geneious summarizes the LR reaction being simulated. If you're happy with these settings, simply select OK. Doing so will create the final expression clone. It's worth noting that Geneious can perform the BP and LR reactions in a single operation, rather than simulating separate reactions. To do this, simply select the files containing your PCR product insert with attB sites, the donor vector, and the destination vector. Then, as before, select the cloning button and gateway cloning. After confirming the correct components in the one-step reaction, you will see the final expression clone. Visit geneious.com for more hands-on exercises and tutorials.